Kristi, first place in the conference. Is that something that you kind of came into the season thinking that that was a possibility? Or has that kind of surprised you the way that how successful your team has been over the last 5-6 games here?
Yeah, I mean, it's always the goal. We talk about it every single year. We talk about it in the off season leading into our competition season. And this year we just have an extremely focused group, and we've had, you know, started off really, really strong, had a little bit of a lull, and it's just really picked up the last few weeks.
What have been kind of some of the keys? What have been some of the differences? Because it seemed like early in the year you maybe played a little more of an open, free-flowing style back and forth than we've kind of seen over the last couple of years, and maybe you guys tightened it up a little bit, and that's kind of been part of the reason you guys have been able to pull out these 2-1, 2-0, 1-0 wins over the last couple of weeks.
Yeah, I think we've kind of gone back and forth, like you mentioned, with just trying to lock it down defensively, but we've struggled to score goals, or at least in volume. Whereas this year we're just really solid everywhere. We have a ton of depth on our team, and also having 11 seniors doesn't hurt.
In terms of kind of going into these last couple games, you guys have a road game against UMBC and a home game against UNH. Just kind of knowing how much is on the line with those and the opportunity to potentially be bringing teams here in a couple of weeks for a conference tournament, how do you kind of keep your group focused on just kind of the task in front of you and making sure you go out and get the result you need in this next game?
Yeah, I mean, fortunately, our mentality and our message has just been focusing on one day at a time for the entire season. So for us, you know, our message week in, week out is go 1-for-1 today in training. And then by the end of the week, the accumulation of what you've put in over the course of the week leads to the result at the end of the week. So that's really just been our message and our focus and our mentality all season. And so I don't expect that to be any different for us. We're already in day 2 of our training, and we said at the end of training, we went 2-for-2, we're gonna go 3-for-3 tomorrow.
What are some of the challenges maybe that UMBC poses for this weekend that you guys have to keep an eye on?
Yeah, I think, and the America East is such a tight league. It's crazy that we're going into the last 2 games of the conference and still nobody's been eliminated and still nobody's clinched as many points as we have. We still haven't officially clinched. And so I think, you know, heading into this weekend, UMBC is fighting to stay alive as well as other teams. So, you know, I think for them, like they're going to have their own set of challenges and their own things that they're fighting for. We're fighting to keep first place. So I think there's plenty of motivation on both sides, and it'll just come down to how we execute.
What's maybe different about this group that kind of has the killer instinct, the mentality to go out there in big moments and perform? Just when sometimes in the past it's been sometimes they've been able to do it and sometimes they haven't been able to do it, it seems like there's kind of more of the like clutch gene, so to speak, this year.
Yeah, we have having so many seniors is a huge bonus for us. They have a ton of experience. And there's a lot riding on the line for them. It's for a lot of them, it's their last year, and so I think there's just sort of like a magic potion halfway through the year for them that you just sort of see come out in their play. And additionally, we just have so much depth that when we're playing each other in training, when we're scrimmaging in training, there are times where I feel like the level of our scrimmage is a higher level than some of our opponents sometimes. And that's not all the time, but it definitely helps having such a deep team that we can push each other the way we do in training. And that when we do sub in, the level's not dropping off at all. If somebody gets hurt or we need to make a tactical change, we can bring another player into the game and bring something different and solid right away.